You're gonna show me how a hidden message is created, a la Pinterest.
So in this example, I pulled up an image related to a recipe. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm actually gonna hide some content in it.
How about like, meet me at 5 p.m.?
Sounds good.
What looks like a recipe on Pinterest for tacos is actually a forum for a hidden message.
And now it's available really for everybody to see.
People are looking at taco recipes and they have no idea that you guys are making plans to meet at 5 p.m. via hidden message.
That's right. We'll open this new image. We've downloaded it. And there it is. Meet at 5 p.m.
The advent of social media and comment culture has made everything more public. But here's something you might not know. Those same platforms you use to publicly post can also host secret messages, if you know how and where to look.
How your average user could do this is they can identify an image that's publicly available on social, download that image, and embed something hidden within it.
And you wouldn't see anything, it would just look like that very same image until someone downloads it.
It sounds like the plot of a bad spy movie, but tactics like this have been around for generations. Spies communicated with invisible ink as far back as the Revolutionary War. And now we're seeing those methods play out in the digital age. It's a process called steganography. Put simply, hiding messages in plain sight. Security researchers Mike Rago and Phil Tully have been studying the ways these secret messages can spread on social networks.
Social media is a very convenient conduit for storing secret messages. It's public, so it's easily broadcastable. It's very trivial to create accounts, fake accounts. And there is just such a high volume of traffic that it's very easy to lose the signals and the noise.
What are the implications of passing these hidden messages through social media?
South Korean banks were impacted by the fact that someone malicious was posting IP addresses embedded in pins and comments within Pinterest, thus allowing them to steal money from the bank. When you think about it from a terrorist type perspective, there is documented instances of them using steganography to communicate over the web. There is the ability to embed more than just a text message. You can do an image within an image, hide audio within a video, but there's always a trade-off. So if I was to make significant changes to an image by hiding another image in it, it might destroy the actual carrier image itself, where it'll look, you know, pixelized.
How prevalent do you think this is?
We've seen, you know, at least 10 to 15 examples of this type of thing happening in the wild. But when more advanced groups and or nation states tend to do this type of thing, they'll include other type of techniques, like they might encrypt the message.
If you follow Britney Spears on Instagram, you may have come across a hidden message yourself without even realizing it. In June, it was discovered that comments on the pop star's photos were actually coded malware instructions.
So you have your profile description, you have your profile photo, you have your background image. There are many different parts of these social networks that you can upload an image that has an embedded message within.
Photos and videos on social media are often compressed or shrunk down so that they don't take forever to load and drain your battery. Now that compression typically would destroy any messages hiding in the metadata. But Phil and Mike were able to create a tool to help demonstrate how bad actors might bypass that. And when the communication is meant to be undetectable for average users, it can also be difficult for social networks to pick up on.
Generally, the social networks do a really good job of defending their users. That said, these things are imperceptible to the human eye.